Comes from Delaware North, the garden's owners, and the Lincoln Company, a large developing firm. It calls for renovations on the arena itself, several office buildings in the North Station area, and construction of a parking garage in the lot behind the garden. This proposal comes
contrary to the public.
We have one more half hour to take another look at the weather. I'll meet you at the map then.
His good days are all behind him.
If it weren't for a bad reputation.
You're a real menace.
He was a champion on the skids, but he knew how to be a father.
I manage Daddy. I always will be.
And he could lose everything.
I don't want to go Daddy.
Including his little girl. Gil Gerard, Lisa Blount, When Your World Falls Apart, Come Storming Home, Friday.
This is CBS.
Celebrate Easter Mass with Archbishop Bernard Law, Sunday morning at 8, only on Channel 7. WMEV-TV.
...front of the building, underwater, and we are just in the process of removing the bodies now.
Chief, are the circumstances of this discovery at all suspicious?
Let me say this. The fire is under investigation at this time, and I wouldn't want to have any further comment.
Do you know anything about the cause of the fire at this point?
Not at this point. It was a fire of serious proportions in which the floor and the roof fell into the building. And it's very dangerous down there in the removal of these two males.
Can you tell us if it appears those victims died as a result of the fire?
I would say they were asphyxiated down there, yes. And then they were burned.
All right, thank you. Chief Edward Berry of the Quincy Fire Department. Two firefighters received minor injuries battling that blaze last night. Right now, the unidentified bodies are being brought out of the basement. Medical examiner is here on the scene along with the state fire marshal, Quincy police, and investigators from the Quincy Fire Department. The owner of the bakery, as we understand it, is not in this country. He is in Lebanon. We don't know his name at this time. There are some people here who played a part in managing the Staff of Life Bakery on Washington Street. Chief Edward Berry just told us that the fire continues to be under investigation. Earlier, I spoke with another fire investigator who said the fire is not being termed suspicious yet, and the cause is officially undetermined. The state fire marshal is on the scene along with police. Reporting live from Quincy, this is Ron Sanders. Camilla?
Thank you, Ron. Ron will have more on this story tonight at 6. Well, Todd says we're going to get a little bit of this and a little bit of that once again for the weekend weather.
That's right, and it all starts within an hour or two, the wide changes. And the first change is good news because it will get much warmer in just the next couple of hours, with temperatures already up to 70 degrees in Providence, Rhode Island, and those warm readings are heading in our direction. Let's take a look now at some of the readings. We have a 53-degree reading right now in Boston with a relative humidity of 68%. The wind's north at 6. The barometer is falling. Phil Adams, our New England weather watcher, our high school weather watcher in northern Worcester County, reports a 50-degree reading, but in southern Worcester County right now, it is a completely different story altogether. The warm front is through there, and it will be through here in just a short amount of time. As a matter of fact, on Easter Sunday, I am expecting some good news, so bear with me as I show you these real quick changes in how it all relates to this warm front. The warm front just south of Boston right now, and it is heading to the north and east. There's even snow up in Maine, so while it's snowing up there, and it's in the 40s as close as about Portsmouth, it's in the 50s now in a very narrow strip of northeastern Massachusetts, and it's in the 60s and 70s, even 75 in Philadelphia to our south. And that warm front, as of a couple of hours ago, was pressing eastward with the breaks in the clouds that you see on the satellite photograph, and those breaks spell out some hazy sunshine for us this afternoon. And tomorrow morning we'll have some hazy sunshine as well. That warm front will be far gone, will be in the warm air mass, but thunderstorms will roll in the afternoon on Saturday with this next cold front. As the cold front comes sliding eastward, we'll get pounded in the afternoon with showers and thunderstorms, making for a wet end to what will start out to be a glorious Saturday. Then Easter Sunday rolls in. Well, the jet stream does favor that cold front not moving too far offshore, and that has an effect on our weather next week. But for the time being, on Sunday, we'll be in a very narrow band of sunshine. I think we'll just sneak out a really good day with temperatures in the 50s, not warm, but seasonable for this time of year, and partly to mostly sunny skies. Then we have to turn our attention for next week. Here's these sweeping changes to another storm, which will be producing both snow and rain down in the Appalachians. And that may affect our weather next week. But for the time being, it's good for later this weekend, starting out with that warming trend this afternoon, up to between 60 and 70, 70 south of Boston, 60 north of Boston, with a hazy sun breaking loose. Tonight, partly cloudy in the 60s. Then, for tomorrow, hazy sun in the morning, over 70, but PM thunderstorms will cool things down. Then for Easter Sunday, partly sunny. Temperatures Easter Sunday will be in the 50s. And I'd like to wish everybody a happy Easter, of course. And you too.
Thank you very much, Todd. So the Easter egg hunt can go ahead as planned.
Absolutely.
Great. Thank you very much. It continues to make fashion headlines. Here you see Di is wearing a daring strapless black formal evening dress while attending the opening of the Wolfson Galleries of Classical Sculpture and Inscriptions at London's British Museum. I'm sure that caused quite a bit of talk. Now, sports this afternoon. Hockey action at the Garden. With a fixed position in fourth place and a playoff berth, the Bruins played like they were in first last night. The Bees knocked off the Buffalo Sabres 5-3. John Dennis tells us that Doug Keynes was terrific in net as the Bruins took control right from the start.
Still a power play. Bork weaves to center ice, lead for Middleton over the line. He's in. Scores! Rick Middleton, saved by Ray Bork, a power play goal, and Boston leads 1-0. Middleton to Casper. Back for Middleton. In for shorthanded bid. Scores! Rick Middleton, second goal, shorthanded, set up by Casper. Around the board, stopped by Bork, moves well in. Fires. Speed shot, scores! Ray Bork makes it 3-0. In by Orlando.
The Sabres finally got on the board midway through the second. Sean McKenna's power play goal makes it 3-1. Jeff Cortnell's slap shot would get Boston right back with that one. 4-1, Boston after two. Ray Bork opened the third with this.
And breaking, Bork picks up Zimmer. Bork fires, scores! Ray Bork makes it 5-1.
The Sabres would get two in the third, but Doug Keynes was spectacular tonight. He turned back 35 Buffalo shots, strengthening his spot as Sinden playoff goaltender for next week. The Bruins beat the Sabres 5-3.
The Bruins have only two more games left in the regular season. They're in Montreal tomorrow to battle the Canadiens and then return home Sunday to play the Toronto Maple Leafs. The Delaware North Company, the owners of the Bruins, wasted little time. After matching a plan to renovate the Garden, they took their proposal to City Hall yesterday. Paul Mooney, John Hines, and a consultant sat down with Mayor Ray Flynn for an hour in a closed-door meeting. Nobody would say anything after that meeting, but we'll keep you posted as the story develops. As for the Celtics, they're back in action tomorrow at the Boston Garden for a game with the Washington Bullets. The Red Sox are taking on the Cincinnati Reds today down in Florida. Yesterday, Dwight Evans belted a three-run homer, and Bill Buckner drove in two runs with a homer and a sacrifice fly as the Sox ended a five-game winless streak with a 6-5 victory over the Minnesota Twins. Finally this afternoon, no matter where you were at 10 minutes to 11 this morning, if you were near a radio, you probably heard the American musical superstar's song to fight world hunger. Radio stations around the world, as well as all the New England News Exchange radio stations, took part in the holiday effort. We Are the World is the song, and at 10:50, it was heard everywhere.
WTAG, Friday morning with Sam, it's 10:50.
This is the USA for Africa benefit on WHDH.
There comes a time when we heed a certain call, when the world must come together as one. There are people dying, oh, when it's time to lend a hand.
A reminder, all contributions to USA for Africa go to fighting hunger in famine countries and to fighting hunger here in the United States. That's the news for now. Join Dion Willis and Kate Sullivan for the New England News at 6. Have a wonderful holiday weekend, everyone. I'll see you Monday.
When we heed a certain call, when the world must come together as one. There are people dying, oh, when it's time to lend a hand to life, the greatest gift of all. We can go on, pretending day by day, that the world somewhere will soon make a change. We are the part of
great big family. And the truth, you know,